Hi guys, welcome to Poland Museum, the museum of the history of Polish Jews, to the theater of life. Through the forest of the history, we reach the times of the Middle Ages. My name is Damian, and I will take you on a journey through the ages. Polin Museum is a narrative museum that presents the history of Polish Jews using audio and video material and a lot of interactive screens. We enter here the gallery called First Encounters. The first person we meet in the 10th century is Ibrahim ibn Yaqub. He was a merchant and diplomat. He was traveling across Europe. That's the reason he mentioned for the first time in history the name Kraków in writing, and he mentioned there was a country ruled by Mieszko, our first duke. Mieszko was a contemporary of Ibrahim ibn Yaqub. His acceptance of Christianity in 966 changed the course of Polish history. In each of our galleries, we present a major formative event from Polish history because, to quote Israeli president Reuven Rivlin, we believe that there is no history of Polish Jews separate from the history of Poland. The first Jews present on Polish soil were traveling merchants, but from the 11th century onwards, they started to settle permanently in Polish towns. Their security was guaranteed by the famous list of privileges called the Statute of Kalisz. And in the 14th century, we meet Kazimierz the Great, the Polish king. He fell in love with this beautiful girl named Esther, the daughter of a Jewish merchant from Opoczno. They had two sons and two daughters. But we know that story as a legend. However, the Polish historian Jan Długosz mentioned her existence in 15th century in his document. Was she real? The Jewish graveyards were usually located outside of the city walls. The tombstones were very modest and a rectangular shape. The oldest mazewa in Poland, found in Wrocław, is of David Sar Shalom, who died in 1203. It describes him as a man of pleasant voice, which means that he probably was Hazan, a cantor. You can find the oldest tombstone over here. That's this one. You can also find what is written on it using this technique of frottage. Let's talk now about the population of the Jews in Poland in Middle Ages, exactly at the end of those times. In 1507, we have the coronation of one of the kings, Sigismund I, whose coronation text was issued. And from that document, we can count how many of Jews were living in Poland and how many cities and towns were populated. This map, recreated by the museum, is showing us the reality. If we look at the taxation list, we see that some communities paid only 2 florin, while others paid 200. Assuming that 2 florin were paid by the smallest communities, we can conclude that the Jewish population in Poland totaled about 5,000. Welcome to the 16th century and the two towns, Kazimierz and Kraków. Kazimierz was founded by Kazimierz the Great in 1335, and at the end of the 15th century, it became the home for the Jewish communities. The 16th century is often referred to as the golden age in the history of Polish Jews. It was certainly the golden age in the history of Poland, which after the union with Lithuania in 1569 was one of the biggest and strongest countries in Europe. It became the Commonwealth of Two Nations. It was also the golden age in the Jewish culture and learning. In the present Kazimierz, we can still visit the synagogue of the most famous Jewish scholar, Rabbi Moshe Iserles, known as Remu. And in the 16th century appeared the document of the Confederation of Warsaw, which was the document saying if you have your own religion, you cannot be persecuted because of that. And so, we could say Poland in the time of the 16th and 17th century was one of the most or the most tolerant country in whole Europe. Jewish printing houses established in Kraków and Lublin published books in Hebrew but also in Yiddish, a phenomenon which accelerated the literacy among Jewish women. Books in Yiddish, such as Cena Urena, a simplified version of biblical stories or special prayers called Tchinot, written by Rivka of Tykocin, were published in thousands of copies. There were books in Yiddish for women with information on folk medicine or tips on how to run a household with such pearls of wisdom as, if you want to have a happy life, you should always listen to your mother-in-law. In the middle of the 17th century, dark clouds appeared over the Commonwealth of Poland and Lithuania. We are in the Corridor of Fire, which describes the uprising of Cossacks led by Bogdan Chmielnicki. Here we see quotations from the book of Nathan Hanover, an eyewitness of the atrocities written in Hebrew, describing the terrible ordeal of the Jews during the Cossacks' rebellion. The scholars who created the Core exhibition always used primary sources. That's why we quote Nathan Hanover in Hebrew. And after the uprising, there was the time to rebuild everything, even the towns. Welcome to the 18th century Jewish Christian town, where we have different buildings. People are meeting in a market area. People are trying to live with the regular, normal life. One of the most popular places in every little Polish town was a tavern, usually run by Jews, who were leasing taverns from Polish noblemen. The tavern was a place where you heard the news from all over the world, as well as local gossip. Here we see the interior of a typical Jewish house in a Polish small town. The house was a realm of women and the Jewish house was unique due to the presence of books. The house was very important, but the other important place was the synagogue. Let's go over there. This is the synagogue of Gwoździec, which was founded in the 17th century. Let's see the beauty and the colors of the synagogue in Gwoździec, which was reconstructed by art students who volunteered from all over the world. The iconography of the synagogue ceiling is very rich and intricate. Some of the symbols are clear and easily understood, like the zodiac signs used in Jewish synagogues already in the antiquity. Some of them have very clear symbolic meaning, some remain a mystery to us. Like, for example, the ostrich is saying that's the creative power of God. The elephant, that's the strength of the faith. The lion is one of the tribes of Israel, which is the tribe of Judah. The rooster was protecting from the bad spirits. It is the time to say goodbye. We had just a quick glimpse at the first three galleries, and there are six more to go. Do visit us and discover the 1,000 years of the history of Polish Jews.